battle begins. Oh, right. Hey, what is that? What's going on, everyone? This is JoeYoursTruly back with another video, and today we are going to be doing something very interesting, and that is we're going to be doing Greystone support. So on the last podcast, or one of the previous, I'm not sure when this video is going to go out, we made the joke that I will be trying Greystone support just for the heck of it, and I figured this would be a good kind of time to do, especially this is like kind of an evening time. I'm kind of in a good mood. This is just kind of like a late night kind of vibe, if I do say so myself. So we're going to be doing something just really interesting in this video, 100%. So I'm thinking for this kind of Greystone support video, by the way, it's not meta, this is just more like a very fun off-meta thing. We can try and make it work. We're going to be trying to do with focus right here. And let's see. I'm thinking like the way you want to do Greystone support is you want to just be like just very, very tanky. And because he's still going to have some good early game damage, I would say. So I kind of want to give Draconum a shot because that's some good physical armor we can get early. It's a good item that synergizes for that kit. So I kind of want to get Draconum early just for the stats it give me and just kind of go from there. Because I don't think there's any like super good support items to go on like Greystone. Just go kind of pure tank. So maybe I'll do a Stonewall second or maybe like a Tainted Guard second. We'll just have to wait and see. I'll go Tainted Guard second because we all get a Kira, so I might just pick that up for her. So we might actually go Tainted Guard first. We just have to really wait and see how this kind of plays out, 20%. So I'm not sure what ability you will take first on Greystone support, but we'll just probably go with Q because if they do try to hook us in, then we just have to take the ability that's really strong in the all-ins, right? So it's kind of really... This is gonna be a really fun game. And I got some teammates that are willing to support my decision in this. He's walking to us like this, so I kinda want to. That's probably not the best Q. I probably should have gone probably E first. Uh-oh. We do a lot of damage, by the way, at base level. I really want to blink after her, but there's another wave coming in, so I'll just hold off for a little bit. But probably there's a E angle right here. And look at that, ladies and gents. We are making this work somehow. Love to see it. Oh my goodness. Try not to bait it, because like I don't want to like make it obvious that the Wenpei's ganking, but this he's really not walking up, huh? So he just have to go for the walk because he's waiting too much time. I just have no CC to really lock down the Victor for him. So he's just gonna go away, that's totally fine. So let's do the... A little bit too far away to help that. So I'm just gonna focus on taking the gold buff with my weapon. That's nice. Okay, on my way. Looks like we are fighting. Very interesting game, ladies and gents. That counts jungle. That counts mid lane. Not sure why she did that early rotation. So I guess we'll take it. So, since we're kind of just ahead at this point, might as well just go into Draconum just so we can start doing more and more damage, right? Yeah, this is definitely one of those games that if you are doing the Friday evening kind of vibe and having the good drinks flowing, this is just a really fun pick, right? So I do apologize if my commentary is a little bit on the slippery side. But I kind of just figured I was in the mood to try this very interesting pick and see if we can make it work somehow. And we see the frame out right there, so it's a good kind of ward to put down there. I might put another one right there, but Webner already did that for me, so that's actually probably fine. So I guess in the sense that playing this Greystone support, you play him just to really deter people from just engaging, because they try to engage on the Remnant, that's when I just pop Q and E, and I just literally just stick to people. Because Greystone as a character is actually pretty good early game, and you get a ton of free stats with your passive, so we can kind of abuse that in the support role, making a very aggressive support early on that can be flexed into an actual tank. So definitely we're putting some DPS down right there. The only reason why I didn't go on that hall is because the gear was here, so we gotta respect her a little bit. So, might go for max E, just because I don't need the gear for Wave. I think the E would be a little bit better to do more consistent damage, and having a low E cooldown is always good. I'm being a little cautious because I'm not sure where the Fame Mail is at. So I'm trying not to like hard engage, right? So I'm just kind of doing some zoning. Alright, we'll see where he's at, so... Okay, he uses ease, so we can play around that 100%. Might be looking to jump on her, potentially. Oh, it's she had the E up, but we just go on the Victor then. There we go, nice. Because at this point, we're kind of ahead of the dual lane, so we should be trying to pressure, especially with how they're kind of playing. Victor's playing a little too cautious, so we're just abusing that fact and going really aggro whenever we can. Those are kind of nice with the Greystone passive. We can eat up a free auto, so it makes it a bit easier to kind of pressure, I would say. She might be so. I'm gonna see if I can get the jump on her. So hopefully she dash away. Yep, she does. Did a little chunky damage. Going hard on the Revenant, so we're actually gonna just DP down the Victor right here. Oh no! The main's got him. That's unfortunate. At least we got the kill right there. I'm somehow 3-0, and that's good because I can actually be a lot, I can contribute a lot of damage. So I'm actually making good use of this, I would say, the gold. A little short on Draconum, but I think we can definitely pick this up, get our mana back, and we look to go back in. So, I'm thinking. Yeah, she's building lifesteal, so ideally we're actually going to be build Tainted Guard second, because when we do engage on her, we want to make sure we can reduce her healing output, and also the Tainted Guard is going to be great for reflection damage when we kind of sit in the ultimate and all that good stuff. We see Fame Mal on the blue side, that means that we play a little show. Luckily the wave is pushing in already for us, so that's always, that's very good. And I have ultimate, so I can get really aggro. Like I can bait out like fights and just be able to live through that. So once again, Frame Out is on this side, so I'm not looking to really engage. We can just kind of wait it out and see how the enemy duo responds. Because you can really tell what's going on based on how the dual lane is acting. If all of a sudden Winter is getting super aggro, that's telling me that the Council of Fame is ganking, right? Trying to get the user E, but she's not. And there's a Fame out right there. I can actually solo this Fame Mal. Just use this to get my health regen back up. Nice, we somehow got the double kill. Maybe the webpage? Yeah, I think he gets them too. So we, that's the power of the Greystone baiting ultimate, because they try to finish us off, but we just pop ultimate. They can't do anything about it, and we have that second life to be able to just keep rolling them down. Because like I say, we actually have a lot of early game damage that we can really take advantage, and the fact that we have our ultimate means that we can like really kind of output that sustained damage without worrying about dying, right? So. Wow, we're 5-0 on the Greystone support. We gotta love it, guys. 100%. I'm kind of looking at mid to see if we can maybe get the counts off guard. And we do a catch her off guard. And we got the kill on the Kalanos mid as Greystone support. You gotta love to see it, guys. So in the 50 seconds of that ultimate, we had to be just a little mindful of how we take engagement, because in that window, they could just kill us pretty easily when not careful. So until then, we just kind of have to play a little cautious. But once we have ultimate, we just kind of go unga-bunga. We don't really care. We take a lot of damage because we are smart and use our ultimate to get that second life. Because Witcher can technically CC lock you down, silence you, stop you from using ultimate, but with that in mind, we just use our ultimate a little bit earlier than we normally do, so we take that into account. So we don't get prevented from using our ultimate. Right now, they're a little bit too close to the tower, so it's kind of hard to engage on them. So until we get them, right now I'm in a better spot for me to engage, but I'm still kind of playing the shielding game. I really want to use her E, there we go, so push her off a little bit. So right now it looks like we're just playing the shielding game at the time being, because Kyo is playing very cautious of us. Mamma's actually coming up behind. Looks like they're disengaging. I wasn't expecting Fame Out to actually come up behind like that. Oh, nice, nice stuff. I might actually invade him. I just hope he'd be a little careful. Because I just want to kill this Fame Out. Yeah, he's too scared of us. We're just gonna make him run away. And once again, we have ultimate, so we're not afraid to like use it to our advantage, right? Alright, he's going back on the camp, but now we're just gonna go back on him, right? How's that fighting you, Victor? Oh, Kalanos is here. There we go. Oh my god, we are just not afraid today, ladies and gents. Oh, I guess the CEO is only ulting the Greystone support. A little unlucky. I actually gave a shutdown to him because I was A-0, now an A-1. So, yeah, that was very interesting stuff today, ladies and gents. So, obviously, gonna be able to Tainted Guard. It's gonna be great against, like, the Fade Mao especially. I'm thinking Tainted Bastion 3rd, because it's gonna be great to reduce the healing of Kalanos, but also Tainted Guard and Tainted Bastion is a very strong combo together. So, we might build building into that tech, so it'd be really hard to kill, but we still do decent amount of damage. So I'm thinking Tainted Guard, Tainted Bastion, and then Overlord 4, so all that HP we're building builds into bonus physical power right there. So on my way, we need a good buff for this. Oh, the rampage is a shadow, they just outsmite it. I'm not gonna be able to catch him. Like, I'm not using my whip focus because I kind of figure he's gonna have his arm B, so he's just gonna dash away and waste it. Whereas I can just save it for the next fight, like let's say on the Kira, we can leap on her, she tried to dash away, and so we can use the whip off the clothes that this is to actually stick onto her. So that's kind of like the strat I'm thinking about doing. I wonder if Kira is walking. Okay, she's not walking towards here yet. I have ultimate, so I'm not afraid as I. That's the Kira blink. The push all the way in, so we just kind of back off. Still have ultimate, so we can still definitely bait out stuff 100%. Wenpei doesn't have his ultimate, I believe, so can't really hard dive this. But I'm baiting it, he doesn't know. I'm taking for the team, and there's the power of the Greystone support. Not only has the early game damage, but also he can be very potent diver, so I'm soaking up all the damage from my team, and they can just follow up just like that, ladies and gents. That's the secret strat of the Greystone support, is you use him for that early game damage threat. If they try to hard engage on your ADC, you have one of the strongest early game damages, which is passive alone, and you just really just wreck people 100%. So you gotta love to see it. And also just the Whip Walker tech is really fun, because you can Whip Walker pull everyone in and all on top of them, so they'll just permit slow, they just cannot get out. They're like, they probably have to use a blink or dash to get out your ultimate, they just cannot walk away if you ult them right at the center. Yes, we're definitely backing off. I'm gonna build Tainted Guard. I'm gonna go for the Tainted Bastion. So from there on then, we're gonna go Overlord Force and last item. We're just kind of play by ear, I guess. So we got Tainted Guard. Now let's go with Tainted Bastion. Nice, nice. By the way, I think I can just run down this countess by myself. I think she's gonna go for the river buff. Maybe she's going for the other one. I'll just rotate over here. On my way. Don't have ultimate for a little bit, but we can maybe. Oh, he might be. There's a lot of people here, so not sure what the focus, but I guess we'll go on the Feimao. Our Feimao's a coward. Let's go on the Victor, since we know he doesn't have a blink like the Feimao. Here's ultimate to kind of just get that HP back. No, not enough DPS. Dang. We did try to limit it right there, and while we're having everyone on that right side, the Revenant's making a push for T2 tower, so we did our best to distract for our ADC right there to get the early T2 tower at 18 minutes. We'd love to see it. 100%, ladies and gents. And I kind of figure, I'm kind of bullying them with a Greystone support. It doesn't hurt to give them some freebies here and there to make them give them some chance to kind of still come back in this game. So looking at the scoreboard, they're kind of even across the board, so I think it's just a matter of we just kind of do what we do best, hold down W key and just kind of run down people and just be really really hard to kill but still doing plenty of damage. That's the only reason why Feimao live out, because he actually had the army fam right there, so he's actually healing back when I was trying to kill him earlier. Okay, counter spoiler right there, let's deward that. Definitely gonna go for a Faintus angle. We have ultimate in about 45 seconds. So something to keep in mind. We're not gonna exactly have it in this fight, but we can still be a huge detergent, right? And it's just a little unga-bunga fest going on today, ladies and gents. I think this is definitely a Faintus angle, so I'll just kind of get started for the team. Oh, they're actually looking to engage on that mid. So that's actually not great because me and Guinea are committed to Faintus, but the other half of the team is committed to killing them. But it looks like they're still doing actually perfectly fine without us, so I guess everything works out towards the end, huh? Is he actually gonna chase down my Rampage? I can fight him. Let's do it. And it's gonna be the FF. The Greystone support tech is just 2 days strong, ladies and gents. I'm actually kind of glad because, like, you saw the all the draft. No one actually picked Greystone. I wasn't really planning to do any support content for today. So I was like, you know what? I think it would be a really great opportunity to do a Greystone support. And luckily, it did pay off very, very well towards the end. And look at that, Greystone support, and we did most damage, ladies and gents. That's what I mean. Greystone is that really strong early game champ with the free kind of physical power he gets for his passive. And once you get ultimate, you can really, really bait out fights. I'm only a little sad the game didn't go on longer, because I think it'd been really fun if I keep doing that interaction with Riftwalkers, pull everyone in front of me, and then immediately, and then all of a sudden, the 3 or 4 people I pull, they're all on top of me, and they're all slowed by 70%, and just makes it really easy for the my team to kind of follow up and do really great stuff right there. But obviously, I don't think this is not going to be the most competitive choice to do on Greystone support. Obviously, this is kind of like a more fun video that I decided to kind of do on the rim and see how it actually performs. And actually performed quite great this game. So, I think definitely doing the more tank route for Greystone is what you want to do on him support. And I think Draconum is just a really great bet because you get that physical armor early that you like, and this is just an item that really synergizes well with Greystone, I would say, in almost any build. So there's just a really a lot of fireball stats you can get on this. So I think Greystone support actually takes really good advantage of Draconum first, and then you saw I was pretty much building tank at that point. So going like Tainted Guard, Tainted Bastion, or like doing stuff like Crystalline or Stonewall. And then eventually, I think with that force iron being overloaded, so we can get that bonus physical power from all the extra health we're building into. And then last item just can be kind of whatever, it can be more, even more tame. Because I think the big thing with Greystone is if you're playing support, especially, I think because you obviously don't have any hard CC, so when you do him support, you just look to W key a squishy and just be a huge nuisance and have even kill threat against it, so they can't just annoy you. So you do your best to kind of soak up damage, do damage to them, they try to kill you, use ultimate, come back to second life, and really just create a lot of space and just grab so much of the aggro from the enemy team. But yeah, that was a really fun game, and I do hope you guys enjoy it. So let me know down in the comments what other heroes, what other builds you want me to showcase. Thank you as always for all the amazing support, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.